some will depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrine of the devil. Amen. And we right there in that time. People knowing who Jesus is, knowing what God's word said required of them, after knowing it, then they, like Israel was back during the days of the judge. And I believe on the Samuel, the last judge, the people said, we no longer want you to tell us what to do, Samuel. We're tired of you looking at us in the face. When you say something, God do it. We want us a king to be like
all right,
you want somebody you can control.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, but all right, he said, I have nourished and brought up children, and they have rebelled against me.
All right now. The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
Look out.
But Israel does not know, my people does not consider.
Read.
O sinful nation, and people laden with iniquity, and seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors, they have forsaken the Lord, they have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward.
All right, hold it right there. He want to say the ox knoweth his owner.
Yeah.
Now that's one of the supposedly dumbest animals on earth.
Oh my God.
Two of them, an ox and an ass.
All right, yeah.
If somebody want to cut you real low, they're going to call you a dumb ox.
All right.
A dumb ass.
Yes,
one or two. You hear what I'm saying? Sure. Animals, what I mean, animals that can't really talk, they have a voice, and they seem to be stubborn, stupid. They're not known for being the most intelligent of animal, of beast, amen. But God now comparing the nation of Israel and, you know, his people, he telling them how stupid, how bad they are, how they done backslid. I believe it said in Jeremiah 3:14, return unto me, O backslider, which, by the way, that's my subject on today. Return unto me, O backslider, for I am married unto you.
My Lord!
He said, amen, but the ox, when you buy an ox or an ass back in the olden days when they did a lot of farming, nobody had to teach that ox and that ass what they did.
Amen.
You got children nowadays, mankind, man's supposed to have dominion over the beast. Children, amen, you got to tell them, amen, what bus to ride. You got to let them know where they live at. But you buy that beast that can't talk, you ain't got to tell them nothing. Just bring him home and put him in the stall. And the dumbest of beasts, the dumbest of animals, supposedly, automatically, by instinct, know where they live at.
All right.
If the boss out there in the field plowing or doing something, something happened to them, that old mule or that old ox gonna find their way back home without anybody telling them.
All right.
Instinct.
Instinct.
The apostle Paul said, brethren, you have no need that I write unto you. Some things we ought to know just by being saved, by having the Holy Ghost in us. You standing here dumb and brother on the cartoon.
Oh,
do you hear what I'm saying? Amen. Not knowing that the things we ought to know, we don't know. But here's a dumb preacher. They know what they ought to know. But when it comes to being saved, when it comes to obeying God, we standing here wasting somebody who never knew God.
My
he said, the ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. They know where they live in automatically, but I have to be told. But Israel does not know. My people do not consider. They don't have a clue as to what's going on.
Amen.
All right.
Amen. Then it's an all-sinful nation.
Yes.
A people laden with iniquity. That's no
doubt.
A seed of evildoers. You know what that means? You come from a bunch of evildoers, a seed.
Hallelujah.
You should be the children of God, but you come look like you come from a bunch of people. Your father and forefathers, they all been rebellious, and you just like them.
All right.
A seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. You should be going out there trying to hold a light to help somebody else get saved. I believe you say, amen, praise God, and let your light so shine before men that they see your good works, but glorify your Father which is in heaven. We raise so much hell in the body of Christ, so much now.
All right.
It's corrupting the focus
Jesus.
Of our
Lord.
In the body of Christ, amen, you see people, praise God. You see people trying to do right. You go up to him and tell him, you sure will look pretty with a little makeup on your face. Child, you got some good skin. You got some nice leg, but you're covering it up with that long dress you got on.
All right.
You're weighing 3 inches above the knee, ain't you? You hear what they say? I got old folk corrupting me.
All right.
Child, if I had a body like that, doing.
Amen.
You're not in there singing about Hosanna. You're in there singing about holy, holy, holy. But while you're singing like holy, you're looking like hell. You're vomit you out. Now he, you done got it. You got it. He's in Zion after knowing God. God. cussing you out for no reason. Come in the church trying to get in service, amen, and you can't get past the argument you just had with your wife. You didn't get it straight.
All right.
What's the matter now?
All right.
Read on.
And since the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah. Hear the word of the Lord, ye rulers of Sodom. Give ear to the law of our God, ye people of
Sodom. Did you hear that? God wants you to give ear. Listen to me.
Yes.
We got God's word nowadays, the sanctified folk, and we do not read and study. 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman needed not to be ashamed, right in the divine word of truth. But we in such a bad shape now, we don't study God's word. We don't know what's going on. If somebody walked through them doors and wanted to know about our faith, we couldn't tell them. Even if we had a Bible in our hand, we couldn't find.